Chag Sameach, Shabbat Shalom, Shalom, happy holidays. Greetings from Jerusalem, Jane. About 20 minutes ago, the rain was pouring down here in Jerusalem. Just remarkable. You have to remember, here in Israel, rain is always a blessing. Shabbat is just around the corner, and from that we go straight into the Passover holiday, Pesach, where the Jewish people are celebrating that after being slaves in Egypt, crying out for rescue, God took a young boy who was saved, and he was brought into the palace for such a time as this, becoming Prince Moses, and God used him to deliver his people out of Egypt, and they made their way back to the land that God singled out through all of the nations in the world to choose as his very own to his own people. What Israel has accomplished since 1948, after 6 million Jews was murdered during the Second World War, is nothing short of a miracle. I have been living in Israel now for several years, seeing the good, the bad, the hard, the joy, the funerals, the terror attacks, rockets flying in from Gaza, and the world don't seem to care. Jewish people being murdered over and over again in their own homeland just for being Jewish. The Jewish nation is strong. The Jewish nation is amazing. And God did put his name down, and he made a covenant with Abraham and his descendants. And the Jewish people are home, never to be uprooted in their homelands again. What about the election? Yeah, I can see your wheels up here are turning, wanted to know about the election. So the Jewish people are home to live in that land that God single-handed chose for them. This is a democracy where they can go and vote, and now they have voted 4 times in the past 2 years. The election result is in. There is no result. Nobody won. In order to make a majority in the Israeli parliament, you have to have at least 61 mandates out of 120, and neither the right or the left side has accomplished that. Right now, the right side, led by Benjamin Netanyahu, has 52, and then there is Yamina with Naftali Bennett, who not officially yet has said he endorsed Netanyahu. If he does, that's only going to bring the total number up to 59. On the other side, it's the camp with Nachnu Bibi, meaning anybody but Netanyahu. But the parties on that side, the Meretz, the Labor, the Arab List, Israel Biteinu with Avigdor Lieberman, and Blue and White with Benny Gantz, and New Hope with Gideon Saar, and then of course also the Ram Party, the other Muslim party, they are so far apart from their core values and their beliefs. Will they manage to put some of that aside to make a government, you know, to make a coalition? They are finally seeing a chance to get rid of Netanyahu. So many questions. So what's going to happen now is that the president of Israel is going to officially receive the election results, and then each party is going to come in front of the president, and they are going to say, this is the person that we are going to recommend to the prime minister of Israel. And when all of that is done, the president is going to retreat, and then he's going to look at all of the answers, and then he's going to invite the person that he thinks has the biggest chance of forming a coalition. Would it be Benjamin Netanyahu? Would it be Yair Lapid? Would it be Benny Gantz? Who knows? Nothing right now. Nobody knows right now. It's all up in the air. So I know I have said this before, but there has literally never been a time more important than to pray for Israel. And that is what God is commanding us to do. Whether you agree in the political situation or not, God is saying, it is my name. I put my name down. I'm commanding you to pray for the peace of Jerusalem, and I will bless those that stand with Israel. Is there anything going on here that you might not agree on? It could be. It's like that in any other country. But this is not just any other country. This is the land of the Bible. This is where prophecies are being fulfilled. Open your Bible and you will see we are living right in the middle of it. And what Israel has accomplished since 48 is the proof that God is alive and he is on this side of this nation, his very own nation. So as we are entering, well, first it's going to be Shabbat and then it's going to be Passover holiday, we rejoice that the Jewish people are home and they're living in a democracy where they can go and vote. So thank you for standing with Israel for such a time as this. Chag Sameach, Shabbat Shalom to Israel and all of her friends around the world. We love you. We miss you. We can't wait to see you back here in Israel at some point. Have a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Bye.